Tonight starts the Jewish holiday of Yom Kippur, and one of the ways the Jews observe Yom Kippur is by fasting. And as someone who works with women and their relationship with food and body, I want to talk about fasting and why maybe you shouldn't fast at all. So first of all, if we haven't met, I'm Nina Mandelson. I'm a body peace coach, and I help women end the war with their food and body. I'm Jewish, and I love the deep, powerful meaning and self-reflective opportunity that each of the holidays offers us. Yom Kippur gives us the space and time to do a moral inventory of ourselves. Fundamentally, I see it as a day to examine who we're being in our life, how we're showing up, how does that align with our deepest values of how we want to show up in the world, right? Do we feel aligned with the core Jewish value of tikkun olam, which means repair of the world? We want to be part of that force of good in the world. Now, fasting is a way Jews observe this holiday. Observant Jews don't drink liquids or eat foods for 25 hours. But in the last 15 years or so, I've been thinking about fasting differently for myself, and maybe you've been exploring it as well. So there are specific reasons not to fast, if we're sick or if we'd be harmed by fasting. So let's talk about what being harmed by fasting looks like if we have a complicated relationship with food and our body. Because I'd like to invite you to explore if fasting is really helping you deepen into an introspective experience during the holidays, or harming you by kicking up disordered eating or disordered thinking around food during the holiday. So if you've been a chronic dieter through your life and fasting would kick up a cycle of deprivation and then binging, that's harmful. If you've tended towards being really restrictive around food and fasting would push you into a cycle of more restriction and mental gymnastics about calories and grams, that's harmful. And if fasting takes you more into the pendulum of I'm good because I'm not eating or I'm bad because I'm eating, that's harmful, right? We want our spiritual practices to support our well-being. That includes our relationship with our food and body. Will fasting support you to connect to your spiritual self or take you down the road of disordered eating? Is fasting going to support or harm your relationship with your body? I hope this has given you some food for thought. And this Yom Kippur, I extend to you the traditional wish of Gemar Chatima Tova, which means may you be inscribed in the book of life for good.